I'm a Brooklyn kid, and it's great to see them actually shooting this in Brooklyn. Everything in there is about that. It's just that real New York feeling.
Brooklyn finest for real.
We're here in the nick of it, man. And I think that Antoine is bringing a gritty, grimy, straight from the streets, hit you in the stomach.
I shot the film in Brooklyn in the Van Dyke Housing Projects. I believe in real locations as much as possible because it helps me creatively. You gotta engage with the people who live there and they bring an energy.
It's good to be able to do it here, and I'm glad that Antoine pushed for that. There's just a realness here that you get to take advantage of.
Well, I always like shooting around the neighborhood. It's nice to work with that energy. It's exciting. I mean, they were throwing some slangs out that I didn't even understand. You know, made me almost forget my lines. I grew up in the Bronx. I was like, what?
It's amazing to be here and see everybody come out and support us, because they don't see this often. What they see is police. What they see is brutality. What they see is drugs. And that's what I add to my character. You know, to put myself in that mind frame of where I grew up at, where people don't care about you. You know, where at any point in time, anything can happen.
It's a pretty rough neighborhood. Police action, everything else goes on. Kids grow up and they see that and they think that that's what it is. That makes it their life because they don't see nothing else outside of that.
Let's go, Wesley, come on.
They pretty much had the whole area involved. They shot outside. They had a lot of locals in the movie.
I live right in the next building, so like I'm giving back to my community. As the little kids can see me doing something positive, that inspires them to do something positive with themselves.
Yeah. When I read the script, I thought there's a great opportunity to bring something positive to the neighborhood, bring my crew to the neighborhood, so that the people can see what goes on behind the scenes.
What's up, Terrell? How you doing, man?
We donated 4 cameras. We gave them to the kids and started a program for them to learn how to make movies.
This is your camera.
Great, thank you very much.
No more excuses, go make your movie.
Right now I'm planning on doing a documentary on how Brownville was when it first started and how is it now.
I'm doing a documentary on my father because he's pretty much like a person you see in this movie. So that's why I'm doing a documentary on him.
On and popping now. See you at the Academy Awards.
I try to make them understand everyone's not a movie star. Everyone's not a director. But you could be a grip, you could be wardrobe, you could be electric. Those are all craftsmen. So if you like the film business, you don't always have to be the high profile job. It's important for me to infuse that into the kids. You can do it too if you really apply yourself.
Don't let nobody say no. If somebody say you ain't, you know what I'm saying? If somebody ain't gonna give you the money, if somebody ain't gonna really help you, you keep pushing. That's the biggest mistake people make, is they stop. You feel me? All right, that's what's up.